It happened 35 years ago today. The accident that would change the course of my life forever.
Mom, what happened?
Peter, hi, bud. You're in an accident.
I can't feel my legs. Where's Daddy?
Daddy's not coming home. He was hit by a drunk driver.
Now, every year on the anniversary of my father's death, I set out to punish the guilty. If I ever catch the one responsible for shattering my life, I'll take extreme pleasure in putting my crutches to extra good use. Until then, those who drink and drive, best beware. Because I'll be out there, waiting.
That's it for me, kids. Peter Wolf signing off. I leave you with two safety tips for the day. One, never, I say again, never play leapfrog with a unicorn. Two, never drink and drive. And please don't forget Horrorfest right around the corner. October 30th, Abbey Inn in St. George, and November 1st at Jazzy's Rock and Roll Grill. It's going to be a frighteningly good time. I leave you with The Cars and Drive.
I can't believe it's been a whole year since the murders.
Man, tell me about it. I can't believe how time flies. And what happened to Jeff? Terrible. The guy was burned to a crisp. Seriously, they wouldn't have been able to identify him if it weren't for his teeth.
I mean, whoever it was, they knocked out two other people that night. Some drunk hooch at a party, and some random Mexican.
Could have been a fourth, too, if Kevin died.
Kevin? The bone man? The humorist? He survived? Really?
Survived? Impossible.
Lucky bastard.
Unlucky is more like it. Have you seen that guy?
Plenty of time before the clock strikes midnight to punish the one who got away. But first, a quick phone call to the most important person in my life.
Hey, Mom. No, everything's okay. I just wanted to check in. Did you visit Dad's grave today? Roses. That's what he gave you on your first date, right? Well, I'm sure he loved them. Don't cry, Mom. I'll come by and see you this weekend. Would you like that? I just have a few things to take care of first. I'll see you soon, Mom. I love you. Bye.
Let's finish this. I have no idea what this place is. I still have a hard time believing you survived. Seeing how I cut your head off at the mouth. But modern medicine has come a long way in the last year. It'll be different tonight, though, because this time, I'm gonna cut your head off at the neck. Where are you, you son of a bitch?
Hi, my name is Candy, and I'm an alcoholic.
An AA meeting? Oh. can't be.
One more meeting, love, and then you'll get your wee check.
Shit. Why?
Not but a year ago, you were ready to plow over innocent civilians, and now you're here? Might there actually be hope for you? Might there have been hope for the others as well? Where do I go from here?
How was your dinner, love?
You remain the finest cook I've ever known, Mum. Mum, what are you doing?
I was just gonna pop down to the shop for a bit.
You've been drinking, you're not driving anywhere.
Don't be so dramatic, Peter. I've had one drink.
That's all it takes.
I'm the parent, not you.
And act like one.
How dare you?
I'm looking out for you, Mum, that's all.
You don't understand.
I do understand.
You don't. I can't get through the rest of the night without this.
That's a crock and you know it. You know, you're not the only one who lost someone. You may have lost a husband. I lost a father.
You see, you don't understand. There's more to this.
More to what?
I did it!
Did what?
I was the drunk driver. I was the one that killed your father. I did this to you.
What?
I'm so sorry, Peter. I'm so sorry that I kept this from you all these years. I didn't know how to tell you.
It's okay, Mom. We'll get through this.
What now? Everything I thought I knew to be true was a lie. On the other hand, it still came down to someone drinking and getting behind the wheel. No worries though, Mum. We're rational adults. We will get through this. I still have you in my life, that's the important thing. And I have Rod Serling to keep me company when I'm down. Oh, and thanks, Mum. Thanks for making me realize that I no longer have to punish the guilty on the anniversary of my father's death.
Mother! Can you keep him in the dark?
I can do it year round!